My dental occlusion is incorrect. Is keeping my teeth in contact still good? So this is a question from the Great Work Forum and the Reddit page, kindly collated for us by Karen, who's the moderator of the Great Works Forum. Now, in response to this question, I would first ask, what is good occlusion? What is considered normal or ideal occlusion today is very different from what it was in the past. There is no wisdom teeth included. This occlusion looks very narrow compared to our ancestors, lacking greatly in the amount of tongue space, and the whole thing, the whole upper and lower dental arches are set back and down swung. So we've got this very different occlusion from our ancestors back in Paleolithic times, our ancestors a few thousand years ago, or what we see as ideal or normal good today. So we could maybe define this differently, define correct as aesthetic. Does it look nice? We could say, does it function well? Can you eat your food? That's functional occlusion. Or clearly, is it comfortable? Which I'll get on to. Now, it's important to remember that the orthodontic profession has been unable to demonstrate any health benefit from aligning teeth. So conversely, it could be suggested that there's no health detriment from having crooked teeth. Now, there isn't even a clear relationship between jaw joint problems, TMD, and crooked teeth. I personally think there probably is, but it's a little bit more complex and it's not shown on the surface. Now, I talk a lot about effective buccal segments, buccal side teeth. So the way that the side teeth bite together, and I think this is very important. Now, in dentistry, we talk about how teeth interdigitate, the way they meet together, they kind of lock together. Now, clearly, again, this word comfort, and I think that's the most important thing. If you look at this image, there's what is effectively carbon paper marks on multiple teeth. And what you'll notice is they're quite large carbon paper marks. They're spread nice and evenly on basically all of the teeth with a couple of carbon paper marks, which is spreading the load and allows an effective muscle effect. So this allows a large force to be applied through the system. Now, the classic example we were given within dentistry was that you imagine you've been invited to an uncle who is a hunter. He shoots game birds with a buckshot gun, a shotgun. You're happily enjoying this meal of game bird, and all of a sudden, a piece of buckshot gets caught between your teeth and you bite down on it. Now, till this point, your body's been making this amazing symphony of motion where your teeth move frequently with fractions of a millimeter separation. Large forces are being applied. It's quite an amazing symphony that stops in an instant because you've overloaded a couple of teeth with the buckshot that's between the teeth. And this gives an important understanding of what. Because controlling your bite, your maximum biting ability. So when one tooth or a set of teeth become overloaded, it switches off the chewing mechanism and inhibits loading. Because this is called a periodontal overload situation. So it's important to have a comfortable, well-balanced loading situation as described in that image. I feel that the most important definition of an incorrect bite is where a few places touch first, what would be known as a premature contact. And this will inhibit the muscle effect, and by definition, this will be uncomfortable. Now, what's important to realize is that teeth will reposition themselves to create an effective bite. In reality, this is a system which has been hijacked by orthodontists to align teeth. Now, to create a comfortable occlusion, you need to maintain a butterfly bite with your teeth in or near contact with the muscles clearly balanced. As I describe in the video, the cause and cure of clenching and bruxing, which is linked, link number one below. Now, if you use the tropic premise, teeth in or near contact, lips together and tongue on the roof of the mouth, progressively your bite, your occlusion will improve until it becomes comfortable with a nice evenly distributed load. This is unless something else is preventing it. The usual culprits would be fixed appliances, retainers, or your tongue. Now, remember that erupting teeth are far more compliant. They're far more willing to move into a position as dictated by these forces than old teeth that have been in place for a long period of time, particularly if the root position of the older position tooth is incorrect. So if a teeth is leaning greatly, it can be quite difficult for that tooth to recover itself. I have a hypothesis that teeth will always attempt to upright to be directly opposing the forces applied upon them. And I make this observation from on watching people as I expand their dental arches. If they're chewing heavily, the teeth move in a more or less upright position. If they're not chewing heavily, the teeth tip. And I have lots of small examples that sort of inform that hypothesis. As a general overview, the muscle effect is one of the most, possibly the primary influence on the stasis of craniofacial form. That is to say, the muscle effect is the most important effect that holds the balance of where your facial form is, rather than if you increase the muscle effect, you're more likely to get an upswing. If you decrease the muscle effect, you're more likely to get a downswing in facial form. Now, I'm not sure if the muscle effect, or what I often refer to as the indirect force through the teeth, is more related to the time the teeth are in contact or the actual force applied, or a more complex interaction of both. However, you need a comfortable bite to apply a effective muscle effect. Without this, there's a massive disadvantage. And I worry that many people are wearing retainers that are preventing them maintaining a comfortable bite. Or even worse, some people's retainers are holding individual teeth in a position where they take too much of the load, a traumatic position. So, in summary, the answer is yes. Follow the tropic premise and always keep your teeth in or near contact with a balanced butterfly bite. And this will make your occlusion comfortable. And when we're asking whether occlusions or the way your teeth meet together is correct, well, comfort is the most important element. Few, if anyone's, occlusion is correct. And comfort is the first step towards improvement. Correct or ideal occlusion is a concept that few of you will ever achieve, but it is important to set your eyes on something, to have a goal.